Welcome back. After hours every Friday night, it happens this way. We enjoy our Friday night here. And today, we're doing some political enjoyment, cum digital, and, you know, we want to know if some parties are more IT inclined than others. We've been joined in the studio by another guest. I'm not sure his name or his position will sound so sweet to some people, but others, they will be enjoying it. We have the CEO of Vocacom Ghana. Is it Vocacom Ghana?
Vocacom, yes.
Yes, Vocacom. Nana Osei Efifa is here with us.
Yes.
Nana, how are you?
I'm very well, Mickey, and how are you doing?
Yeah, I'm all right by the grace of God. Nana,
good.
Are you a 419 agent? Tell me. You're a 419.
Mickey, me nye 419. Me a businessman. Ah, me sell me business. Yeah, I check.
Yeah.
From 2003,
yeah.
And as a student in tech,
mm-hmm.
I started writing software.
Okay.
And then that's where I started my company from. My year, up to a certain point, of course, like all budding entrepreneurs, I suffered some setbacks. I had to go and learn how to run businesses. And then I picked myself up again. By the grace of God, since 2011 till date, every year, give or take, I'm making somewhere in the region of about $10 million a year.
Honorable Namwale in the studio. He will join in the discussion very soon. But until then, let's listen to how to make money. Yes, especially from government.
Okay. Yeah, yes. When we started off, we have never really done government business.
Okay.
We've chosen to stay away from government business, and it's for good reason. In fact, if anything at all, this digital address has told us that it was for good reason that we had to stay away from government business. Up until this time, from 2003 till now, many of us said there are many companies, there are many people who knew us apart from the businesses that we were doing business with. And for a young man, I've only made it 35.
Okay.
You know, for a young man, I'm clocking somewhere in the region of $10 million a year.
Yeah.
I mean, I can say yeah, yeah. And in all of it, you know, we've kept very quiet and we've done our job without fuss, without anybody disrupting us with anything at all. You know. Now,
okay.
2015.
Yes.
And
you are coming to...
I'm coming to the digital address.
Digital address,
you know.
Yeah.
So 2015. Mm-hmm. And your business, when we started to boom, the business was going on, you know.
When you started to get the $10 million.
You know.
Yeah. Can I sign up? $10 million, my market.
$10
million. Okay. Initially, I was hearing Ghana Post GPS thing.
Yes.
Now I'm hearing a national... address
NDPAS, digital
property
yes
address system.
Yes,
what has been the difference?
Okay,
because
it's the same product. See, this is what happens. Now Ghana Post invited proposals,
yeah,
right. Now in that proposal, primarily there were two things that we were supposed to do. What we call the Ghana Post GPS platform and the Ghana Post GPS app.
Okay.
It is the app that is in everybody's hands. And no, that's the one you can download, and people are downloading for free.
Okay.
So far, we have about 180,000 people who have downloaded the app. You know, but the app sits on a platform. That platform is not the app.
Okay.
You know, there's a difference.
Okay.
The platform is the one that we have used survey data to tell everybody's digital address. That is the one that we say there are 5x5 meter now,
yeah,
with postcodes and
yeah,
all those things.
That
is
the district
system, the district, the region.
And
the
you think
survey.
you can't find this on Google
at all?
Why?
Sure. What happens?
Because Google now, and your latitude, new longitude, now Google now, and you know, I don't know.
Yes. Latitude and longitude, they are all worth it.
Uh-huh.
In fact, Christopher Columbus time, near latitude and longitude. The main issue is the finances. You see, TV3 were Adisawe.
Okay.
The only reason I hear from her Adisawe, and yes, Adisawe.
Adisawe.
And yes, effect and IBBR.
Okay.
Your latitude and longitude, that all the social will be home. But latitude and longitude, no, your bomb hour, yeah. So we to media two team, no one should share.
Okay.
And then anypa started say your name streets near your house numbers.
Okay.
So they be easy. And then they say me catch you say me wo longitude 777-3411 and latitude ben dia ben no. Yen ka say me wo Adisawe.
The naming of streets ni routes are important to what you're doing.
No. Okay. Naming of streets, you know, I'm just building on say address.
Okay.
Address
system.
And yeah, just a translation of longitude and latitude,
okay,
into human readable formats.
Right.
Easy to read, easy to remember. And across the world, yeah, you yaye street name ya ba ye mayi mu yaye street name ya yaya enfa yinkosi babia. The digital address okay. No, is supposed to translate your latitude and longitude into a human readable.
But the other platforms that provide the same things.
Of course.
Because I tried some other platforms.
Of course.
And they generated a digital address system.
Yes.
And okay.
Well, so all these platforms, uh-huh. Are we still on?
Yeah, we are still on.
All these platforms try to provide you with digital address. In fact, any Ghana kwani ya digital address. Cote d'Ivoire ya digital address. Nigeria ya digital address. Mongolia ya digital address. Entina nye se?
In fact, as much as,
there were 28 companies that put in a bid.
Okay.
Of the 28 companies, no, one of the companies ya nimso ma ye bida, ewa another country, no, put in a bid of over 38 million Ghana cedis. Ye the 9.9 million. Ah, 9.9 million ye iti nkuwampo. And you money in our account.
Okay.
9.9 million. 38 million. Obi, I am so I be the way you do in your bidder. Obi, so so bad. 170 million.
We got you for cheap.
Oh, yeah.
We got you for
because,
cheap.
Because, again, and you are the number guy.
Honorable. Come on, ke hotel to ake. Make you a junior. Let me ask. Julo, ne? I love you, Mali.
Oh, Jejulo. Okay,
I
mean, you.
Company
Jalen.
Okay, you can't 419.
We'll not pay
NBCB care 419. 419 Paddy LNA.
Mickey.
What should we ask him?
Yeah. When Baumia was, His Excellency Baumia was launching the project.
Yes.
It is unique. You cannot find it anywhere in the world.
Not even in
America. Nobody, not even in America.
Not even in
today, they are mentioning Mongolia, Nigeria, and China. Elsewhere. Mongolia, Nigeria, and other.
But there's been some weeks.
You
days.
See the 419
no, probably
Cote d'Ivoire. Cote d'Ivoire.
A week after.
So there is one in Cote d'Ivoire, uh-huh. Nigeria, and Mongolia. So is it unique?
No.
Is it? It has never happened in any country.
The
so you see another 419. This is where we are talking of. This is the 419. Some of the 419. In fact, it's a Gargantuan 419. So it is the one that happened in Cote d'Ivoire, uh-huh. And the one that happened in Mongolia, mm-hmm. And Nigeria.
Yeah.
Eh? It's the same thing that is happening in Ghana. Well, we were agreed to believe that it has never happened. It is unique to Ghana and it is only Ghana. Meanwhile, the Ghana digital address system, mm-hmm. Is being used in China.
Can somebody use the address system in China?
No. It is not true.
Are you sure that if I'm in China now, I cannot find my address?
Using the Ghana Post platform?
That
is not true. Now let me explain this. Let me explain, very true.
What you are paid for?
Chinese people are using it.
I'm telling you.
Chinese people.
It is very true.
Now let me explain this. Let me explain.
Copyright infringement.
Yes. Let me explain this really well. Now when we built this platform, the Asase GPS platform, when we finalized it, it was a global address platform.
But you did it almost for free for your business.
Oh, it's for my business. But it cannot be for free for my business. It cost me money. It cost me a lot of money to put it together.
How much did it cost you for your business?
In fact,
did it cost you a million?
You know, right now, the ROI we have on Asase GPS, mm-hmm. Actually
what is ROI?
Return on investment.
I'm not talking of Asase GPS. We don't know IT. That's what
I'm talking of Ghana GPS.
Ah, okay.
NDPA system.
GPS.
Now,
that's what I say. It's being used in Nigeria. It's being used in China.
Now,
I'm not talking of Asase.
This is what happened.
Okay, tell us.
We built this platform on a global address system.
All right.
You know.
Which one?
The Asase GPS.
No, I'm talking GPS.
The Ghana Post GPS is based on the Asase GPS technology.
It's almost the same.
It is based on it.
It is the same.
Yes, it's.
You just rebranded.
This is what we did.
Okay.
28 companies came for a bid.
Mm-hmm.
We were one of those 28 companies. In setting up our system for the bid, we put Asase GPS and said, Government of Ghana, we have a platform that can give you digital address.
Already.
Are you happy to use this one? They said yes. And you know, nobody has gone anywhere to say, as I see, GPS is very different.
What are some of the exceptional features
of this GPS that makes it different from any other? Yes.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So those are the two issues. Let me quickly touch on this one. Now, when we put this in app, right, we went to NIA.
Mm-hmm.
NIA, don't forget, are the ones who really need this one because everybody who is supposed to get an NIA card necessarily must have a digital address.
Yeah.
Now, NIA then said, look, our mandate is not just...
That's National Identification Authority. Yeah.
That our mandate is not just to register Ghanaians in Ghana. It is to register Ghanaians even in Nigeria, in New York, and all these other places. How are we going to do it when we only have national digital address that only works in Ghana?
Mm.
That was when we had an agreement with them that, look, This platform works across the whole world. It's not just for Ghana.
Okay.
Now, what we will do is we'll give it 1 week and we'll open it so that you can see it everywhere
in the world.
Across the world. Now, when that time comes and you need to go and register somebody in Nigeria, we have given license for Ghana. If you want to use the Nigeria one, come and see me. That is how businesses make money.
So,
and so we opened it for a week. Okay. And in that week, people could see across the world that the platform works across the world.
Did you tell the vice president the right things? That it's never happened anywhere in the world, even in the
United
States.
Now, in the
U.S., yes.
Now, let me give you this.
Such a vice
let me give you the
No, are you the one who told the vice president this?
No, I don't advise the vice president.
But when you were listening in, when he was saying, this has never happened in America, this has never happened in New York, this has never happened in the U.K., this has never happened in London, what were your thoughts?
Now, this, what we have done, you see, what we have done technically on the digital address front is a revolution.
Okay.
But you see, because it's a technical revolution, it's very difficult to explain the uniqueness of the entire system. What we have done, every digital address system in this world runs on pure mathematics. So you give them your latitude and longitude, and then they run a bunch of numbers in mathematics and give you what your digital address is. That's how the system has always worked. What makes us so different is the fact that we reference map data. Map. So when we tell you you are in Greater Accra, we are not buying our team any catch us over Greater Accra.
But there is when I Google my address and position, it tells me I'm in Greater Accra.
Yes.
Sometimes it even tells me the district in which I am.
Sometimes. You see, you said sometimes.
Well, I've never had any time that it didn't tell me.
Have a look.
Yeah.
Right now, did you really know? Mm-hmm. I mean, these are some of the small things that we found out.
The way the man is looking at you.
These are some of the small things, right?
You don't know.
Now, did you know, for example?
The way the man is looking at you.
For example, take it. I'd be very happy for us to explain what this is so different about
this. Yeah, tell me now. Let's get to the
bottom. Take, for example, right? Say, the airport technically is not in Accra.
Where is it?
Kumasi Airport technically is not in Kumasi. It's in Asokore Mampo. Technically. You know, these are things that when you play around with the Ghana Post GPS, you will actually start to see a lot of the things.
That's the difference between the other ones, like the Google.
You see, the Google and the rest, they are private companies. Like we did for Asasi GPS. Yeah. We are private companies. We do our own private thing. We are not accountable to anybody for the data to be correct or wrong.
It's that important for us to note that we're a big man of you, so you could have about 10 different addresses.
And it's important to note, as a big man, you can have a big house. But when someone is looking for you, the person will only call on you at your gate. Nobody will come and look for you.
So they will use the address of the gate.
The address at your gate. Okay. And we have said this over and over.
Okay.
And Honorable Namwale has heard this say, use the address at his gate. And he intentionally goes to sit in his toilet and generate the address and give to somebody. And to Honorable, yes, Ramo, Yaka, on a more serious note, what person will be better show? The person will look for you.
Generate your address
at your gate. That is always going to be.
I have another. I simply be kind.
Okay.
Reference point. Verification.
Yeah.
What through the telephone number? Who will verify? Say, Adi my no cre.
Okay. Give it. Program name is a never do but that's a me answer honorable question. But I'm very happy to do it.
I think it's educated.
I'm very, very happy to do this.
Because Your Excellency Vice President, or see NDC Vomu Nim IT.
And I am happy to educate.
To help Your Excellency to educate NDC people.
Now this is what happens. Miggy. National Digital Address. A property addressing system.
Landed property
addressing system. There is another system that is coming. IFN, National Identification Authority. National Identification will identify individuals. So, and you know, that time is coming up. When you put your name and your details in the digital address, we will reference those details, you know, verify using your national ID.
You live in a compound house where the address is being picked off the gate.
Yes.
So how can they, differentiate between people who have the same, 10 people who share the same gate? at the National Identification Authority.
Oh, Mickey, sir, even if you remove digital address, take off my digital address. I grew up at McCarthy Hill, where I stayed with my father.
Yeah.
My father's address was my address. Everybody, if we were even 100 people living in that house, that was our address. Okay. Nothing stops any 100 people from sharing one address, because nothing stops 100 people from living in the same property.
Mickey, honorable, your final question.
Move a card, mommy. Makoja last cemetery.
Yeah.
Anymore, more. Majority my digital address.
Yeah.
Now, because national identification, but there are no akushim. How will you verify? Say, baby, me chest cemetery no. I am passing.
Oh, you send in some ghost names.
How will you get it?
Answer. How you can?
Now, this is what happens.
You can differentiate.
You see, there are various ways we look at their addresses, right? But the addressing system, no, is a long-term project, and you one day assume. The key thing in there that people, I think, as part of the education process we have to do, is what we are calling the National Address Register, which is when you go to NIA and give them your address, that address gets logged in. Once it is logged in, when you go to your bank, your cemetery address. So assume you say, yes, honorable has put in cemetery address. No problem. Nobody will say anything.
Yeah.
Put your cemetery address and go home.
When
so
you go
you've gone
bank,
home.
What happens?
Now, your ATM card expires. You go to the bank and you say, oh, my ATM card has expired. I need a new one.
Yeah.
They'll say, okay, no problem. Fill this form. You fill the form. And then they'll say, Mr. Namwale, we are going to send your ATM card to you. We'll bring it to your house.
Okay, thank
and
you.
And the address we have there is actually in cemetery. Cemetery. Honorable. Oh. It's not where you live.
Honorable.
Bro, now
you
say yes.
You are talking about honorable. 20, 30, 50 years to come.
Honorable.
You are talking of a neck. Now, 419. And what's a neck?
You see
the flaws in it.
You see
the flaws in it.
Mickey, sometimes, you see, that is some of the problems we have.
Yeah.
Short-termism. A problem, my power.
Okay.
Sometimes some problems are solved over a long term, others are solved over a short term. This is a long term solution. And to honorable Nyabotre, no one solution. No one said this is a long term solution to a long term problem.
All right.
It is not a short term solution.
I think